All right, so we are ready for our fifth and final sprinkle popsicle. So we're going to take the rectangle tool and we're just going to make a rectangle. And then we're going to go and pick a nice yellow color and go to your direct selection tool. And this time we're going to drag in all of the points so that they're the same radius this time. Go back to the rectangle tool and you're going to draw a rectangle that fits about a third of your popsicle. Go back to your selection tool and you want to hold shift so that the rectangle you just made and the original popsicle are selected. And then you're going to go to the shape builder tool. This part can be tricky. But what you're going to do is you're just going to click once on each of these three sections. So one, one, one. Go back to your selection tool. And what essentially this did is it divided your area into three spaces. So click on this like white area. Click on the top and you can make it a nice chocolatey brown. Click on the middle section. You can pick any colors you want, but I'm going to pick a nice little pale pink. So I'm going to double click on this fill area and pick a nice pale pink. And then now it's divided into three sections with three different colors. So the next thing that we're going to do is we are going to add some sprinkles. So I'm going to take the line tool. And I'm going to zoom in so I can kind of see what I'm doing here. And I'm just going to make a straight line by holding shift. I'm going to make my stroke weight 4 points. And I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. Go to my stroke panel, round those edges so it looks like a sprinkle. And I'm going to click the selection tool so I can see what I'm doing. So I need a couple different types of sprinkles. So I need to duplicate the same exact shape and size. So if I hold Alt on my keyboard and just drag that sprinkle, I can get a duplicate image. I want to hit Control D twice so that I have a total of 4 sprinkles. What you color your sprinkles is totally up to you. You can click and color one of your sprinkles white. You can color it baby blue, pastel yellow, pastel orange. It's totally up to you. But I know that in the stroke panel, there's only so many colors available. So what's kind of cool about Photoshop is if I go to the fill and I hit the library, there's all different kinds of options that are hidden. If you're looking for pastels, I use the color books, pastels, and neons. And there's some really cute colors in here. So I'm going to pick a powdery blue color. You might see it pop up in the fill. All you have to do is hit the swap and it'll swap the colors out. So I'm going to click this one here and I'm going to make that pastel pink. Again, you might have to swap the colors in order for it to show up. All right, so now what we're going to do that we have colored all of our areas and all of our sprinkles is we're going to put the sprinkles on the topmost part of the chocolate. So I'm going to zoom out here and all you have to do is just make sure you're on the selection tool. If you hold Alt, you can drag various colors around and you don't have to worry about where you place them. They don't have to be rotated or anything like that yet, but you're just going to go ahead and place them in kind of a staggered pattern. So now that you have your sprinkles all spread out, what you're going to do is with the selection tool, you're going to drag your mouse over your sprinkles, but you don't want your brown to be selected. So if you hold shift and click the brown area, your brown top won't be selected anymore. What you're going to do now is you're going to go up to Object. You're going to find Transform. And you're going to go to Transform Each, because we're going to transform each of these little sprinkles here. So in this panel, we're going to configure the rotate angle setting to 360 degrees. Then you're going to check the random option. So you might have to kind of look around here, and it's right here. So check the random object option. And then I like to click preview to see what it's going to look like. That's totally up to you. You can change the angle if you don't like it, but I'm going to stick with 360. And then I'm going to hit OK. So now you can kind of click off and arrange your sprinkles however you want. If there's a sprinkle that kind of goes off and you don't like it, you can individually click it and hit delete. If there are ones that are touching that you don't like, you can move those around. So just take some time to edit your image. Sometimes you'll accidentally click on the brown. Just make sure that you put it back where it belongs. And you want these to look natural. You want them to look good. And then go ahead and zoom out when you're done and see if you need to do any more little touch-ups. But I would suggest zooming in for selecting each of those sprinkles. So the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to select both the middle and the bottom shapes of your popsicle. So you're going to select the middle and the bottom by holding shift. And then what you're going to do is hit Control C to copy, Control F to paste in front. And what you're going to do now is in the Pathfinder, you're going to hit Unite. What this is going to do is you're going to see it change to one color, and that's okay. You're going to right click on that shape, and you're going to go to Arrange, Bring in Front. We're going to go back to the watercolor textures, and you're going to pick a texture that you like. I'm going to look through here, and I like number 16, but pick a color that you like and open it with Illustrator. Okay, copy it by hitting Control C and then paste it with Control V. And you might have to zoom out and resize, make sure you hold shift, and you want to make sure that it covers that popsicle shape. Now I moved it over the popsicle and I noticed that it's not, the pink part's not showing up. So again, you might have to right click, arrange, bring to front, just to make sure that it pops up in the front. So you want to move your watercolor over, and then you're going to hold shift, make sure your watercolor is selected, click your pink or whatever color yours is so that both are selected, right click, and you're going to make a clipping mask. So we can't really see the sections that well. So we're going to have to make sure that our blending mode is changed. So my window kind of disappeared, as you can see. Anytime that happens to you, all you have to do is go up to the top here and find the window that you need, which is the transparency window. And just play around with the different options. I'm going to try screen. I happen to like that, but if you don't like it, change it to a different option. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to click that top chocolate shape. So make sure you're not clicking the sprinkles, just click the chocolate part. And you're going to do Control C to copy, Control F to duplicate and put it in the front. And then you're going to carefully right click on the brown part, go to Arrange, bring to the front so that your sprinkles are no longer there. And I'm just going to take that same texture that I used before and copy it. So I use number 16. Paste it. Resize it. Make sure it can fit in there. So I might have to make mine a little bit bigger. Okay. And again, if you're putting it over your chocolate and you don't see that chocolate on top, again, make sure you right click on that shape and bring to the front. Until it shows up. Once again, you're going to hold shift and make sure both the watercolor and the brown part is selected. And then you're going to right click and then make a clipping mask. And we want it to blend together with those sprinkles. So I'm going to go to my transparency window, and this time I'm going to select multiply so that I can see my sprinkles. So I'm going to zoom in so you can see what's going on with my sprinkles. My sprinkles have all those little textured patterns on them. So I'm going to basically move this shape back to where I can see all my sprinkles once again. So I'm going to minimize this window and this window here so you can see what's going on. So if my chocolate is selected, I can use Control and then my leftmost bracket to start bringing it to the back. And as you notice, the sprinkles will start popping back up. So you can kind of hold that so you don't have to click it a million times until you see all of your sprinkles come back. Okay, if you go too far like I just did, if you do Control and then the rightmost bracket, you can go back to the look that you want. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom out here and I'm just gonna make sure that I put a popsicle stick on this last popsicle. So I'm gonna click my popsicle stick, hold shift, click the shadow, and then I'm gonna hold alt and drag so I can duplicate it. And I'm gonna wait until I see that intersection line so that I know it's exactly in the middle of my popsicle. As far as finishing touches, you can put a background on your image. You can add textures, all kinds of stuff. You could export this to Photoshop, but I'm just gonna keep it simple for this tutorial. So I'm gonna take the rectangle tool and I'm just gonna draw a rectangle over my whole area. And you can make it whatever color you want. I'm just gonna pick a light blue. I'm gonna make this a little bit lighter. And if I take my selection tool and right click and arrange, send it back, I now have a background. If for some reason you want to move your popsicles, all you have to do is select your popsicle and move it. I would do that before you put a background on. So if you wanted to move your popsicle, just draw a selection over it and move it as needed. But I would do that before you do the background. It's just a little bit easier. But you want your popsicles evenly spaced. Feel free to add any extras, any text. But again, this is just a tutorial. So I hope you had fun.